What started as a vision to build a guest house for pilgrims coming to the Galilee took an entirely different direction. After breaking ground, the project turned into an extensive archaeological site, providing a colorful picture of life at the time of Jesus. CBN's Scott Ross takes us to Magdala, the city many believe was the home of Mary Magdalene.
Located on the western shore of the Sea of Galilee, Magdala sits at a crossroad of Jewish and Christian history.
Magdala is very significant, already just in general culture. One of the most known figures of Christian discipleship is Mary of Magdala. Mm-hmm. What's the importance of Magdala for the Jewish people? It's a first century town and a very significant excavation in the first century for the Jewish culture.
In 2005, Father Juan Solana initiated the Magdala Project to highlight the ministry of Jesus and an opportunity to honor women of faith. They broke ground in 2009, and what happened next, Father Eamon Kelly describes as providence.
We bought this piece of land, and then to find it in Magdala, the land, and not just on any hill around the Sea of Galilee, and then you start digging with two prayers, Lord, spare us from archaeology, because it's an expensive hobby, and then a big delay for all the project. The second prayer was, if you do give us archaeology, give us something good. And so we find this incredible discovery of a first century synagogue.
Seated in the synagogue, Father Kelly told me about some of the features that make it so amazing.
So we're in a very big room, and we see it's organized with two rows of seating here in the central part, and we have another row of seating inside the outer walls. This is a space that's not a family home. It's a very ornate community room that has this mosaic and the frescoes. And the mosaic has two parts, the rosette mosaic with the three colors, but now the specialists are telling us there are 26 colors in the mosaic. And then we have the unending pattern, which shocks some people, but they say this was also in the temple in Jerusalem. And then we have the Magdala stone right bang here. This is the place where we found it. Now this and the one out there is our copies. It's considered and treasured by many archaeologists on the level of the Dead Sea Scrolls in terms of archaeological importance.
Archaeologist Moti Aviam proposed the theory of the Magdala stone, resembling the second temple of Jesus' day.
And I suggested that what we have here is some kind of a model, symbolic of the temple in Jerusalem. We have the menorah, we have the altar, the golden altar, we have the showbread table, and we have a scene into the Holy of Holies.
Because of the commandment against graven images, Aviam says the choice was to portray God symbolically in a divine chariot.
As it is in the book of Zechariah and many other books from the Second Temple period, which gives us a description of the chariot on which God is riding.
So what is the significance then of Magdala going back in biblical history?
Magdala today gives the largest view archaeologically of the time of Jesus.
While there's no physical evidence that Jesus visited Magdala, Father Kelly says the signs are there.
Scott, every day, every group asks me this question, was Jesus here? Was he in this synagogue? Was he in Magdala? And I say, we don't know because we lost all the videos. Jesus was surely present in Galilee, and right. This is on the path from Nazareth to Capernaum. Right. There's a port here, and he's always crossing the lake. This is a Mecca for the Galilean Sea and fishermen.
At Magdala, the Duke al-Azim Center is a place for people of different faiths to worship. Its Latin name is taken from Luke, where Jesus tells Peter to launch into the deep. The atrium is designed to honor the Jewish women who followed Jesus in the New Testament. Four smaller chapels include mosaics illustrating biblical events. And in the boat chapel, a unique boat-shaped altar overlooks the Sea of Galilee.
When the gospel is proclaimed up there at the microphone, it looks like Jesus is preaching again to us from the boat. Imagine you're having liturgy here, prayer, and the boats are going by. It allows people to get into the moment of the gospel happenings.
And downstairs is the Encounter Chapel, where Father Kelly says he believes God is healing divisions between Christians and the Jewish community.
This is part of the road of the first century port. So you know the names of many first century fishermen? So who walked on this street?
Yes.
Now, if Jesus came to Magdala, I say he was more often on this street than he was in our synagogue.
Magdala is staffed in part by international volunteers.
Sometimes you realize like you know very little of your faith, so this helps you to go like deeper inside and really to live all the things that you can find out in Israel.
I never been in Holy Land before, so it was taking a huge risk. It was very surprising to see how what we think about Israel, the Holy Land, and coming here and seeing the reality.
And that guest house for pilgrims? It opened just recently.
What's the vision for the future now?
We had to make quite a few adjustments because of the archaeological discoveries, which enriched the site immensely, enriched it with meaning. And then by finding a synagogue, a huge increase of the Jewish-Christian dialogue, and also the Christian-to-Christian encounter, because here we have a place where we were not divided. So where Providence is going to continue taking this in the future, I think we'll all be surprised, as we are every day.
Scott Ross for CBN. At Magdala in the Galilee, Israel.